Okay, this is Ben Faruqi for Boxing News TV in association with ES News. I'm here with Doncaster's Reece Mould. How are you doing today, Reece?
Yeah, not too bad, mate. Yourself?
I'm good. You've got a fight coming up on the weekend. Tell us a bit about your upcoming fight.
Saturday, hopefully. Get a good 6 rounds in there. Ready for my next fight in December.
So you fight something in Oldham on Steve Wood's show. You signed with Steve Wood. Tell us a bit about how you came to getting with Steve Wood.
I was doing a bit of sparring with one of my old gym mates from amateurs, and he invited me down to Freedom to do a bit of sparring with Gavin, Jamie, McDonald. So then I started doing some sparring with them, and then Josh asked me to help a couple of camps with him, and I got in with his dad, and then his dad put me on to Steve. Gone from there.
Okay, what's it like working with Josh's dad, Sean? He's a bit of a character. Tell us a bit about your relationship with Sean.
Oh, it's like, I think you've seen for yourself what it's like. But yeah, we have our laughs, but it needs to get serious. We get serious and we get down to it and do what we've got to do.
Okay, so what? So far you've had 10 fights, 5 KOs, undefeated. What are your goals going forward? Where do you see yourself progressing for the rest of this year and going into 2019?
I'm looking to get a good 6 rounds in on Saturday night. Got a tough opponent. I think he's only been stopped once in 70 fights. And Jamie Quinn. So get a good 6 in there, ready for, because I've only gone 5 rounds so far. December is going to be a 10-round fight, so I can do get in some rounds in there, get some experience, hopefully pick it up for rounds and see how my fitness is looking and see where I'm at, ready for December.
Will we see you on Josh's card on the 22nd?
Well, they told me if I get him out of there before the 4th round in December, they'll let me have another run out.
Fantastic. So when are we going to see you challenging for titles?
Hopefully in December first. Waiting on Steve Wood to sort that out for me.
And that will be an area title, English title? No, the English is vacant at featherweight.
It's been won by Zaid, depending on what he's doing. So we could fight for that if he wants to defend it, or unless he wants to hand it back in. The English is vacant at the minute. I know Lee Wood's down for that. So we just have to see whatever comes and whatever Steve says I'll do.
Would you take either of those fights, Lee Wood or Zahid?
Yeah, definitely, I'd take any fight. It's just down to my team, whatever fights they want me to take. And I'll take them.
Okay, fantastic. So you've been sparring partner for Josh Warrington a few times. I remember watching you spar him before Kiko Martinez fight. It was a great little spar that you had there. Tell us a bit about what you learned from sparring with Josh and what it's like sharing a ring with him.
Yeah, we do a lot of sparring with Josh. I've been asked to help out for this camp for Frampton, so I'm doing a lot more rounds for him, which is good for me from a December fight as well. But yeah, definitely, if I can mix it with like to Josh, with world title, and doing what he's just done to someone like Selby, and I can hold my own with someone like that, going into someone who's not a boxer at his level, that just my confidence the world would.
Definitely. So just staying on Frampton fight, how do you see that fight? Obviously you're going to pick Josh to win, but how do you see that fight going tactically and stylistically? Do you think Frampton's still got it? A lot of people say his tank's gone. You know, how do you think feel about that fight?
Yeah, obviously I'm not going to get too much away.
No inside secrets.
But I think Josh will win. I think it'll be a good fight to watch for the fans. There'll be plenty of punches thrown, but I definitely believe in Josh to win quite comfortable, just like his Griselda. Josh's boxing ability is very, very underrated, and it does things what people on the outside of the ring can't see. I think he's going to shock everyone again, and he's going on as underdog, even though he's world title champion again. And I think he's going to win a lot of people a load of money again.
You know, as someone who knows Josh, and I know Josh a little bit, but like when people would ask me, oh, Josh is fighting Lee Selby, and they'd write him off instantly, you know, casual observer, or even some hardcore fans.
He's the underdog. He loves going in there and everyone against him. He loves that. He thrives off of that. Some people don't, but Josh definitely does. I mean, he's been an underdog in most of his fights, his step-up fights,
yeah.
starting from the Commonwealth title when he boxed Samir,
yeah.
going down to Walter to box him in away corner, right way through, and he's been an underdog, and oh, he's going to get beat, and I don't think he's ever been beat.
He thrives off it, but like, I found myself before the Selby fight feeling like I'm constantly defending Josh here, but I think I've got a valid argument of how he'll beat Selby, and I generally thought he would beat Selby, and he did. But do you get that from people you know, like, oh, Selby's good?
I get it off my mates all the time. I seen some comments on Facebook the other day, some local lad saying, we're all Frampton. And I thought, whatever.
Yeah,
I mean, some of my close mates, I told them to put some money on, and they all won a good few hundred quid a piece on Josh. Yeah, they were thanking me.
Yeah, I bet they were. Let's hope they listen this time. Okay, so just moving away from yourself and from Josh, this weekend, O'Hara Davies, Jack Catterall, tell us how you see that fight going.
I think Catterall distance. I think it would be a decent fight to watch, but I think Catterall with his skills, his boxing ability, I think would be a bit more than O'Hara. Yeah.
And we've just seen Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury go through three press conferences. I was at one of them, it was a bit crazy. Did you catch any of those, and what did you make of it?
I watched a few of them, and he's just hilarious, isn't he?
Big Dosser.
Yeah, he's Big Dosser. I fight you twice on a Sunday. But yeah, I think he's doing the same as what he did to Wilder, and he's getting under his skin. But I think Fury will do it on the night again. I think they've just been making him miss all night long. But yeah.
Hey, do you think it's a more interesting fight than if they'd have, either of them had been fighting Joshua? It's like the biggest puncher versus the most technically gifted heavyweight. Or do you think fighting Joshua would have been more exciting?
I'd probably say Wilder is probably more exciting because of his knockout and that way he fights. But I'd probably prefer to see the Joshua and Fiore, just because the two Englishmen and fighting for our country against each other.
Okay, and finally, another big fight we've got coming up next month is Usyk Belyu. What do you make of that fight? Think Belyu can do it, or is Usyk just too good?
I think Belyu's boxing ability is definitely underrated yet again. And he's another like Josh. He thrives off of that. And that's where he gets his fire from. I think that'd be a good fight. I think Belyu could do it, you know, yeah.
One rumour we've heard is that Manny Pacquiao signed a two-fight deal with Al Haymon, and that him and Floyd Mayweather will fight on the same card in December, but they won't fight each other. Apparently, Pacquiao's fighting Berto, and Mayweather might be fighting Broner. What do you make of that? And is it good for boxing? Is it something you want to see?
Yeah, I think it's good for boxing. I think they're both, Mayweather and Pacquiao, past the best at now, but still good fights. I believe both of them will come through winning. But then I think Mayweather will beat Pacquiao yet again.
Okay. One last question, actually, is that there's been talk that Dillian White and Derek Chisora might fight on the same night as Josh. Now, if you were fighting on the undercard of that, obviously those are two conflicting cards, big fights. How would that affect you as someone who's trying to sell tickets and make a living as a boxer on an undercard?
Well, I think the tickets would sell just because they're fighting, so I think the fans would just buy them just because they're... Yeah, it's not good for boxing fans, really, is it? Doing that. I can't see why they can't be made on different weekends apart from each other. It's just not fair on the fans paying all the money.
And do you see, is there, I mean, I suppose you won't know if there's any solution, but do you feel that it's like just a war game between the two promoters?
Yeah, they're definitely warring again. You see who can put the best shows on and everything like that. It's business at the end of the day, and they're both trying to beat each other. But for the boxing fans, it's not right.
Fantastic. It's been a pleasure speaking to you, Reece. If anyone wants to find you on social media, where can they find you?
Find me on Twitter. Mind you, I don't use that much. But it's Reece Mould, and then I'm on Facebook, and that's Reece Mould as well.
Fantastic. It's been a pleasure speaking to you, mate. All the best in the future.